Hi students, this is KTK. For the new subscribers, let me introduce our channel. In our channel, we are going to solve mathematical problems lively which are prepared from outside of your textbook. I am sure that all these problems will be helpful to you while preparing for competitive Olympiad exams for the classes 6 to 10. If you are thorough with particular concept, you can pause the video and solve, play it and check your answer. We'll start our class now. Okay, we'll start with the first question. The basic elements of square are, your options are 4 sides, 4 vertices, 4 angles, all of these. So imagine a square. We have been learning about square since 3rd standard. So we know what are the properties on square there. It has 4 sides, it has 4 vertices. 4 vertices means what? Corner points, and it has 4 angles. So here our option is D, all of these. So whenever we are attending objective type questions, kindly go through all the 4 options, because sometimes all the options also may be correct. Okay, so answer for the first question, the basic elements of square are, it has 4 sides, 4 vertices, 4 angles, therefore your answer is all of these. Now we'll move on to second question. Which of the following has 2 endpoints? Your options are option A, ray, option B, line, option C, line segment, option D, none of the above. Here we know what is ray. Ray has one endpoint and it extends another side endlessly. And then we know what is line. Line extends on both the sides endlessly. And option C, line segment, which has 2 endpoints. So here, when comparing ray, line, line segment, which one is measurable? Line segment is measurable because it has 2 endpoints. So the correct answer for second question is option C, line segment. Now it's third question. The number of circles that can be drawn with a given center is, your options are option 1, 2, 3, infinite. That is, they are asking how many circles can we draw using one center point. Now look at the right side. I can draw 1 circle, 2 circle, 3 circle, 4 circle, 5 circle, like this. I can draw more number of circles using one center point. So the answer for third question is infinite. Using one center point, I can draw n number of circles. If the same question can be asked in another way, for example, if I'm asking you, how many center point does a circle have? How many center point does a circle have? What is the reverse? A circle will have only one center point. Whereas in this case, using one center, I can draw more number of circles. Now we'll move on to the fourth question. Area bounded by a chord and a major arc in a circle is called as dash. So we know what is meant by chord. Chord is a line segment which connecting any 2 points on the circle, and we know what is arc there. Here the options are given as major sector, major segment, minor sector, minor segment. So just imagine a circle and a chord there. Okay. Now they are asking the area bounded. They are asking the area bounded by chord and a major arc. Okay. Here, so this is your chord and this is your major arc. So in between, this area is called as what? Major segment or sector? Major segment is the answer, because we know that sector is nothing but it will be covered by 2 radius and 1 arc. Here segment is covered by 1 chord and either a major arc or minor arc. So in this case, the region which is covered by chord and major arc is major segment. So your answer is option B, major segment. Here is our fifth question. The least number of line segment required to make a polygon is, your options are 1, 2, 3, 4. That is, minimum how many line segments we need to make a polygon. So we know what is meant by polygon. Polygon is a closed figure enclosed by line segments. So here, for example, I am drawing only 1 line segment there. It's not a polygon. In case if I am drawing 2 line segments, it's also not a polygon because it is not closed. If I add 1 more line segment with that, it will become a triangle which is a polygon. So minimum we need 3 line segments to make a polygon. So your answer for the 5th question is option C, 3. Next, question number 6, how many diagonals are there in a pentagon? So you know what is meant by pentagon? Pentagon is a polygon which has 5 line segments as its boundary, or we can say it as a 5-sided polygon is pentagon. So let us check the options. Your options are 2, 3, 4, 5. The question is how many diagonals. So here we are going to solve this sum in two methods. One is based upon diagram and another one is with the help of formula. First, just to draw a pentagon there. 5-sided polygon is a pentagon. So I am going to draw diagonals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So how many diagonals I drawn there? 5. So answer is 5. In case if you want to do the same with the help of formula, means you are going to apply it in the formula n into n minus 3 by 2, where n is number of sides in a polygon. So in place of n, substitute 5, 5 into 5 minus 3 by 2. So you have 5 into 2 by 2, 2, 2 will get cancelled. So your answer is 5. So using formula method, you can easily find number of diagonals for any polygon. For example, if they are asking for a 10-sided polygon, 12-sided polygon, means you are not going to draw the diagram. Directly you can substitute in the formula, you will get the answer. It's the 7th question. A line segment has, so we don't know what they are asking exactly. We'll check out the options now. Infinite length, fixed length, no length, none of these. It's a very simplest question here. We know that a line segment has 2 endpoints, therefore it is easily measurable. So it has a fixed length. So the option for 7th question is fixed length. We'll move on to 8th one. What is 3 or more lines called if they pass through a common point? What is 3 or more lines called if they pass through a common point? So our options are parallel lines, intersecting lines, concurrent, or none of this. So imagine the diagram. So here I am giving you many lines, they are passing through one single point. Okay, here name of these lines when they meet at one point is known as concurrent lines, because we know that what is meant by parallel line. Parallel line is lines which do not meet at any point, and option B, intersecting line is lines which meet at a common point. But here all the lines are meeting at one point, so these lines are called as concurrent lines. Now we'll move on to 9th question. Here your 9th question. In a quadrilateral ABCD, the part AC is known as. Your options are angle, diagonal, side, and none of this. This is just a concept based question. Just imagine a rectangle. I am here. Rectangle is a quadrilateral, we know. So ABCD, what if A and C are connected? So what is the name of this line? We know that the line segment with joining the opposite vertices is known as diagonal. Therefore, option for the 9th question is diagonal. Similarly, the same quadrilateral has BD also diagonal. So AC is one diagonal and BD is one diagonal. So all the quadrilaterals will have how many diagonals? 2 diagonals. Now the question number 10, how many vertices are there in a hexagon? So we know how many sides are there in hexagon. Hexagon is a 6-sided polygon. What is meant by vertices? Vertices means what? The corner points. So here the options they gave 5, 6, 7, 8. So imagine a hexagon. So if I am denoting it with the P, Q, R, S, T, U, how many vertices are there? 6 vertices are there. Therefore, answer for the 10th question, vertices in hexagon is 6. That's all for now, students. If you like this video, hit like and share it with your classmates. Kindly comment your feedbacks as well as which chapter you need in the upcoming days. Do comment. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get the immediate notifications whenever I'm coming with new videos. Thank you for watching. Bye bye. Take care.